Hello and welcome to Railway World, your schoolboy blazer's pocketful of railway videos from the internet. And in amongst the old bits of string, the dead frog and the tissue paper that's been there rather too long, we've got some videos from Romania, Eritrea, New Zealand and Australia. And also, inevitably, like those Aussies winning at cricket, apart from those ashes, we shall arrive at Train Crash of the Week. But let's start with a rather beautiful film from Romania. There we go, lovely film. There's more of that to come, and I'd love to be able to credit that to somebody, but I couldn't actually, with all my searching, find out who I should say thank you very much to for that. The director is given in the credits as Devil Genius. Is that really a Romanian name? Some steam now from Australia.
Thank you.
Lovely old locomotive number 3658 passing through Newport. And many thanks to Trevor Gibbs for passing that video along to us. That's Newport in Australia, of course. There are loads of other Newports around the world. There's three that I can think of, for example, here in the UK, one in Gwent, one on the Isle of Wight, and one here in Essex. Then, of course, in America, there's even more. There's one in Washington, Arizona, and Kentucky, one in Rhode Island, one in North Carolina and Oregon, and one in Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Vermont. I did have a look for New Zealand, but I couldn't find a Newport there. No idea why, but I did find this rather lovely miniature railway climbing up through the jungle. Was actually built for a purpose, that railway, to bring clay down to the potteries, but of course the railway has now become a tourist attraction in its own right, and I for one would love to go and tourist there. The Drive Creek Railway, that is called, and it's in New Zealand. Rather lovely. Now, as indeed is this old Fiat rail car, which is running in Eritrea. Nice, isn't it? An old Fiat rail car there in Eritrea.
In other spheres too, the accent has been on experimentation and thinking to the future. British trains, for example, with their proud history, are today setting new standards in comfort and performance. At this exhibition at Battersea, London, we take a look at some of the first results of the £1,200 million modernisation and re-equipment plan for the railways. Like this 3,300 horsepower diesel-electric prototype, most powerful yet built in this country. Locomotives like the Deltic, with its classical lines and tremendous efficiency, it has a maximum service speed of 90 miles an hour, are undoubtedly more than worthy to follow in the great tradition of the giants of steam that have always captured the imagination of boys from 8 to 80. Less attractive, perhaps, than the Deltic, but more versatile, is this 1,000 horsepower locomotive, the first mainline diesel-electric to be delivered under the plan. Among the prototype passenger vehicles on view, showing what the trains of tomorrow will be like and built to test public reaction under service conditions, is this attractive first-class carriage with the emphasis on comfort. Note the individually adjustable seats. Another carriage of a different design, this time second class, features more legroom by having six seats fewer than in those now in service. These carriages are also equipped with a special powder room for the ladies. The kitchen buffet car, already in service and the basis for this type of car built in the future, is designed to operate with adjoining saloons on services where there is a demand for meals and light refreshments, but which do not need the use of a full kitchen car. Apart from that, it looks nice. Another service that has already been tested successfully is the restaurant buffet car, a self-contained unit with a saloon seating 23 passengers and a buffet. Amenities like these will undoubtedly help realise this great plan to make British Railways the best in the world.
Yeah, the old British Railways there. Back in the days, you'll note, when passenger coaches were built specifically for comfort. Rather laughable nowadays, isn't it, in these days of airline-style seats? Okay, now this next clip has got nothing to do with railways whatsoever. In fact, I think it could be a strand we'll introduce into this programme. This, however, gave me a bit of a shock when I saw it. There's no sound, but see if it has the same impact on you. Yeah, hard to know what to say about that really, isn't it? Other than, shall we have a look at it again? There you go, and I'll tell you what, while we're on a bit of a high, let's give ourselves a dose of Train Crash of the Week, which in this programme comes from Russia. Now, it's a test, it's only a slight impact, but look at what it does to the second carriage. That's it, Train Crash of the Week, bringing us to the conclusion on this week's programme. It's my last show next week, but that's not the end of Railway World. Somebody will be taking over after that, so keep your clips coming in. mark@therailwaychannel.com, please. We'd love to see them. It's what keeps this show bright and fresh. See you on the next one. Bye.